Welcome to Headline News 24/7. Please click like and subscribe. White liberal woman outraged over black man's bumper sticker, lets him know, bad idea. Famed martial artist Bruce Lee said, "I'm not in this world to live up to your expectations and you're not in this world to live up to mine." Yet many people in America today spend a significant amount of time doing just that. Feminist contributor for the Huffington Post and spokeswoman for the national advocacy group We Are Woman, Kimberly Johnson epitomized the antithesis of Lee's philosophy when she offered a tweeted assessment demonstrating the utter narcissism of the leftist progressive thought process. Johnson tweeted, and later deleted, her opinions on an affluent black man and his apparent support of the NRA and the Tea Party movement. She stated, "Out on the road the other day I saw an affluent black man driving a BMW with two bumper stickers. One was pro-NRA and the other one was a Tea Party sticker that read, 'Don't tread on me.' This left me very confused." In response to Johnson's tweet, many people expressed their own confusion, confused that Johnson was confused about something that is pretty obvious to most free-thinking people: people are individuals. The confusion these folks expressed in response to Johnson's vapid and one-dimensional assessment was further compounded by her pinned tweet, which proclaims to one and all, thread dedicated to anyone complaining about the #MeToo movement, "Stop explaining how women should behave or feel." Apparently, in Johnson's mind, it is perfectly acceptable for a white woman to tell a black man how he should feel. Yet women? Well, they get to do and be and think as they please. She was immediately condemned, with most social media users accusing her of racism. One such person tweeted in response, "It's not confusing to people who don't judge others based on their skin tone. You should try it." Another man tweeted a response to Johnson's blatant double standard with "I got nothing." To which, Johnson doubled down and replied with, as another person said, "Law enforcement repellent." Yet another Twitter user tried to make sense of Johnson's obvious lack of self-awareness and propensity for shoving people into ideological boxes based on little more than superficial characteristics. He tweeted in response as to a few theories for Johnson's confusion, stating, "Theories: 1. Blacks stereotypically don't like certain adhesives. 2. Nobody should put stickers on a BMW. 3. Liberal doesn't understand philosophical consistency. 4. Liberals disapprove of blacks becoming affluent because then they might lose the Democratic vote." To which Johnson dug in her heels even deeper, doubling down on her original point, claiming, "The Tea Party does not work in the best interests of African Americans, or women, or brown people." Along with a link from Vox entitled "How Southern Racism Found a Home in the Tea Party." Journalist Jason Howard tweeted in response to Johnson, "One of the most racist things ever are people who think black people must all think alike and vote for the same party." Fox News reports - Johnson attempted to defend her tweet, saying she was merely confused and didn't mean to tell black Americans who they should support. "It's not about skin tone. It's about people voting against their own interests. The same can be said for anyone who isn't rich and white," she wrote in one tweet. She also accused the Tea Party movement and the GOP of not representing everyone and helping only white, rich men. Amid the turmoil, the author erased the controversial tweet and explained the reason for the deletion. "I deleted a tweet that questioned why African Americans would support the Tea Party, and people saw that as racist. I do not see the GOP working in the best interests of people of color or women. I never said anyone should vote any particular way. I said it confused me," Johnson tweeted. "I deleted it because people were putting words in my mouth and changing my original intent. For the record, I do not believe everyone should vote the way I do. However, I am free to wonder what motivates people to vote," she added. Apparently, according to Johnson, black and brown people are one-dimensional and only allowed to drive certain cars, live in certain areas, think certain thoughts, and no deviation is allowed. It seems she simply sees skin color rather than a free-thinking individual person with a mind of their own allowed to believe however they choose, regardless of whether or not people like Johnson agree or not. It seems in Johnson's small, narrow way of thinking, the only authentic black people are the ones that espouse the same or similar ideologies to Johnson and her elitist bubble. As one Twitter user was quick to point out, it appears that Johnson believes it is impossible for black people to hold any political view outside of liberal Democrat. The idea that black people believe in freedom is somehow perplexing to Johnson. Just how much more elitist can one be and still claim to be woke?
That was the news. We thought you might be interested in knowing about this. Please click like and subscribe. Thank you.